Hey, there you are. Come here. Look at this. Look at this. And look under the desk. We've got a rodent problem. Once rodents are in a school building, you don't have much choice. You have to manage them. IPM, Integrated Pest Management, is the way to do it. And I'll show you how. Let's start by figuring out what we're dealing with, a mouse or a rat. It makes a difference. Mice and rats live differently, they behave differently, and their food preferences are different. Learning about each one will help you get rid of them. Now let's see here. The most common rodents in schools are house mice, Norway rats, or roof rats. All of them are fast and sneaky. You probably won't see them long enough to identify. You'll have to rely on where you see them and the signs they leave behind. House mice are smaller than rats. They like to live in cluttered areas and wall interiors. Norway rats like to burrow in soil or live in sewers. In buildings, you will likely find them on the ground floor or in the basement. Roof rats like to be up high, so you'll find their nests in attics, false ceilings, and in trees.
The reason you're not likely to see a mouse or a rat running around is because they're nocturnal. The most common sign for a rodent is droppings underneath shelves, in cabinets, in water heater closets. Look for grease marks or smudges. Rats rub up against door jams, pipes, and rafters, leaving greasy smudge marks. And listen for noises. Rodents in wall voids and attics make scratching and scrambling sounds as they climb around.
How many rodents are too many? Yes, there's such a thing as an acceptable level, because not every sign of a rodent requires action. Obviously, one rat in the kitchen is a much bigger deal than a mouse in an outdoor tool shed. Think about the health and safety risk, and consider the cost of potential damage. Rodents can eat and contaminate food. They also gnaw on packaging materials, electrical wires, wooden structures, and insulation. They can also transmit diseases. Rodent proofing is your best tool against these pests. How do you rodent proof? By closing up gaps a quarter of an inch or larger. This door needs weather stripping. And this one, a door sweep. A mouse can fit through an opening the size of a dime. And a rat can squeeze through a gap the size of a quarter, which is why you need to make sure everything fits tightly. The good thing about rodent proofing is that it also doubles as energy conservation. So tell your boss, you're saving money. Openings like this around water pipes, vents, and utility cables need to be sealed. Always put copper mesh in the opening before sealing it with appropriate sealant, because if you don't, rodents can chew through the sealant. Roof rats can climb trees and get into the building from the roof. Cut back trees and shrubs so they don't provide an entrance into the building. Rodents like to live and travel in sheltered areas, so remove dense vines or ground cover next to buildings. This will also help you control other pests. Consider putting down a layer of coarse pea gravel, 6 inches deep and about 2 feet wide around the building. This will discourage rodents from burrowing under the building.
Now imagine I'm a mouse, and I'm out here, and it's cold, and it's raining, but in there, yum. Oh, I'll find a way in, sooner or later. Yeah, it's nice in here.
So once you've rodent-proofed the building, you have to get rid of any food, water, and shelter inside. Store food on wire racks in sealed containers. Sweep and mop the floors daily. Vacuum cracks, crevices, and under appliances. Take the trash out daily. And don't give rodents places to hide. Get rid of clutter. If it's not clean and tidy inside, you'll still attract pests.
So now suppose the building is rodent-proof, and I'm stuck out here for good. Hey, there's garbage. I love it.
Make sure you clean out here too. And make sure all garbage cans and dumpsters have tight-fitting covers and they're kept closed. Place the dumpsters and recycling bins as far away from doors as possible, and always keep the kitchen doors shut. If rodent proofing and cleaning doesn't keep your school rat and mice free, you may have to try trapping. To talk to us about that, we have Jim. He is our structural IPM professional. How are we doing, Jim?
Great.
Jim, we've got a problem. We've cleaned the school, we've sealed the cracks, we've removed the food, and still we have rodents. What do we need to do? Call in the National Guard?
I'm afraid that won't help.
No?
No, the next step in the IPM process is trapping. And with trapping, we have several advantages over baiting alone. The first is, when we trap a rodent, we've got a body. We know we've been successful. Second, when rodents consume bait, they'll move off to an undisclosed location somewhere and die, and that can produce an awful odor.
You got a name for that?
Yeah, we call that rodent's revenge.
Woof. All right, you have any tricks or tips for us to help us catch some of these little beasties?
Sure, are we talking about rats or mice?
Let's talk about rats.
When it comes to rats, they're cautious and smart. And they have a behavior called neophobia, which means they're afraid of new things. So we need to do some pre-baiting on the traps. I like to use almond butter and some raisins on the trap. Sometimes I'll even use a prune. And I set the trap 2 or 3 days in the place that I want it. And then the third day I'll come back and actually set the trap, and that's when we'll catch our rat.
Pre-baiting. I like that. Does that also work for mice as well?
No, not necessary. In fact, mice are very curious, so you can go ahead and find the area of activity and set those traps the first day.
So mice are curious. You know who's also curious? Kids. We have a lot of kids in the school at all time. What's the best way we can help the kids avoid traps in these situations?
Well, whether it's placing these stations after school hours and collecting them first thing in the morning, or placing them in a secured station like this one here so there's no access, it's very important to make sure that kids are never able to get around a snap trap of any kind.
So I'm ready to place some traps. I just grab a few of these and place them just anywhere?
No. Rats and mice like to follow edges. They like to stay close to walls. So we want to make sure that we place our station close to walls in areas of rodent activity. And in inaccessible areas, a good technique is to place traps end-to-end along the wall so you can get them coming from either direction.
So placement is important.
Placement's everything.
Well, I know I learned a lot, and I'm sure they have too. Thanks a lot, Jim.
You bet.
You see, a trap is the best idea. Rodenticide should be used only as a last resort after all other IPM methods have failed to give adequate control. Most rodenticides can be used only by a licensed professional. So if you get to the point where you think a poison is necessary, hire a pro. We're not done with rodents yet. In our next video, we'll talk about those relentless underground tunnelers. Gophers, stay with us.